Hey there, new ABC Trainerize users. My name is Nathan, and I'm a product educator here. I'm going to walk you through how to build a training program from scratch. So if you're new here, you're going to pop into Master Libraries, and you're going to see Programs here. Now, think of the program as the umbrella that really houses everything from the client's workouts to the messages you want to send them, cardio activities, progress tracking, and it all really starts right here. So we're going to hit New, Build New. Keep in mind, you might see something different if you have anything under the studio plan, or if you don't have the video add-on, you won't see this on-demand option, but it's a great option if you want to include a library, kind of like a Netflix library of workouts that clients can follow. Now, that being said, for what most people are doing, they're going to use this phase training program. So we'll pick a name, let's maybe say sample program 2.0, pick how many phases, how long it is, and then you're just going to hit save here. All right, so first I'm gonna go ahead and find it. Sample program. Perfect, so it's this one here. You click it open, and then there's a couple things you're gonna wanna do. First, we wanna make sure that the phases are named what you want. So usually I'll go like 1.1 and then maybe 1.2, whatever you wanna name it. And then make sure that there's some instructions here for your clients. You might say week one, onboarding videos, watch those. You know, week two, we'll focus on core, whatever it is. Just give them an outline of what to expect. And then thirdly, we want to either import some workouts. So you can take workouts from our programs already loaded in here. You can take workouts from other clients' work plans that you've already built, or maybe other trainers that you're working with. So for example, if I go into the shared library, I can go ahead and pull in cardio assessment for week one, and then some other how-to videos, like how to customize your dashboard, for example. Perfect. So what we've got there then is the option to schedule those workouts. So we can go right down the line and go every Monday. Obviously you're not gonna do that for all of your cardio assessments, so maybe just week one. And likewise on day one, I'm gonna plan out a little video explaining some things. And then the second thing I can do is actually build workouts from scratch. So let's just say I go sample one. I'm feeling extra mean, I might go just straight abs for today, straight core. And there's some other videos explaining how to build a workout, so we'll skip this step. But essentially, once the workout's built, you have two options of how you're gonna schedule these workouts. Like go down here, right? Go in here, like I showed you. Or if you prefer to look at things from a macro level, you can go ahead and click on a certain day, add workout, set up the repeat option so that's every Tuesday, for example, and then I would go ahead and select that sample workout I just built, and I'm going to go ahead and add it. Bada boom, bada bing, you've got all those workouts there every Tuesday. So that actually applies for things like cardio, progress tracking, and auto messages, like I was saying. So for example, if you want to have a little motivational message sent out, you could just say, hey, get after it today, Roday, whatever. And then, sorry, I'm having trouble seeing over my camera. Add that in, and now, of course, I can schedule that. If you have things like check-ins, I usually do those every Sunday, scheduled on Sunday, and that's all mapped out within this program. So there you have it. That's really the gist of your program. You could go ahead and build out each phase in advance, and the client will only see the current phase that they're on. So just make sure that you're clear on how long each phase is and where they're at in their journey. Oftentimes, if clients miss a week or two, I will extend a phase so that they stay currently on that, and I'll just schedule in some additional days. But the long and short of it is that you build the program here under Programs and Master Libraries, and then you can go ahead and either add people to that program here, or once you're in a client's view, add it to there. Account. So if I wanted to add a program, I could go add, subscribe, and then I go ahead and take that program I just built and decide when it's going to start. And then he's going to go ahead and have that program ready to go. So hopefully that provides some clarity on how to build a program, how to apply it to somebody. And if you have follow-up questions, be sure to reach out to our help team. Take care.